Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Yogesh Pawade. In this lecture series on clinical enzymology, we are now switching on to our fifth session, which is going to be on enzyme profiles in prostatic disorders. In this prostatic disorder, we are going to discuss two enzymes, that is acid phosphatase and prostate-specific antigen. So, coming to the enzyme profiles in prostatic disorders, these are the specific learning objectives, and as the specific learning objectives are given in the description box, I am not going to discuss these specific learning objectives here. Now, coming to acid phosphatase, its enzyme classification number is 3132. It is orthophosphoric monoester phosphohydrolase. It has acid optimum, and there is alkaline phosphatase also, which requires alkaline pH. What are the sites? Sites are mainly prostate cells, RBCs, platelets and WBCs. See, in all these four tissues, you will find high concentration of acid phosphatase. The normal reference range is 2.5 to 12 international unit per liter, that is total acid phosphatase. Yeah, but there is prostate specific acid phosphatase also, of which normal reference range is up to 1 unit per liter. So that is more specific, and we need to study this isoenzyme for the diagnosis of prostatic disorders.
Coming to the isoenzyme of acid phosphatase,
we find here there are 4 isoenzymes: LMW low molecular weight phosphotyrosine protein phosphatase, lysosomal acid phosphatase, prostatic acid phosphatase, tartarate resistant acid phosphatase. These are the 4 isoenzymes, and you know there are the respective coding gene which are different for each isoenzyme. So ACP 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And depending on the stability with the tartarate ions, those are differentiated. So like tartarate resistant acid phosphatase, which is of bone isoenzyme of acid phosphatase, so it is rich in osteoclast in bone, not osteoblast. So tartarate resistant acid phosphatase is present in osteoclasts, not osteoblast. Okay, so there can be an MCQ on this. It is stable with tartarate ions. Another isoenzyme which is stable here is LMW phosphotyrosine protein phosphatase also, which is present in RBCs. So, two tissue isoenzymes are stable with tartarate ions, osteoclast and RBCs. But whenever we specifically mention tartarate resistant, that is acid phosphatase of bone isoenzyme only. So, we will not consider RBC isoenzyme when we say tartarate resistant. Okay. And the isoenzymes which are not stable with tartarate ions are lysosomal acid phosphatase and prostatic acid phosphatase. So, prostatic acid phosphatase is inhibited by tartarate ions. That is also an important factor on which you can find a VIVA question or MCQ. So, these two factors like tartarate stability, stable osteoclast isoenzyme is stable, and prostate isoenzyme is inhibited by tartarate ions. Okay. Coming to the clinical significance of acid phosphatase, the activity is found to be increased in obviously CA prostate, Gaucher's disease, Paget disease and hyperparathyroidism, because prostate tissue and bone tissue. The acid phosphatase activity is primarily studied in and found to be in high concentration in prostate and bone. So, the pathologies related to prostate and bone are going to show you increased acid phosphatase activity. Paget disease, where you see the osteoclastic activity is more. So, you will find ACP increased in Paget disease. And hyperparathyroidism, hyperparathyroidism increases osteoclastic activity in bone. So, you will find the expression of ACP more in case of hyperparathyroidism, because acid phosphatase is present in osteoclast in bone, not osteoblast. Remember this. CA breast, osteolytic mets. So, secondaries of CA breast, carcinoma breast, going to bone and causing lytic lesions will show you increased acid phosphatase activity. Simple per-rectal examination. Per-rectal examination is done clinically to assess prostate size. So, the simple manipulation of the prostate tissue because of per rectal examination will show you increase in acid phosphatase activity. Then thrombocytosis and myeloproliferative disorder, because RBC also have one isoenzyme of acid phosphatase, will show you total acid phosphatase activity increased. Coming to the prostate specific antigen, this is antigen, but chemically it is an enzyme. It is alpha seminoprotein or kallikrein 3. It is a glycoprotein enzyme and it is a serine protease type of enzyme.
Bound to alpha 2 macroglobulin and alpha 1 antitrypsin.
Very small fraction is free PSA. So mostly we can estimate total PSA and free PSA. So estimation of free PSA will be more beneficial when we are going to diagnose prostate pathologies. Coming to the sites where you find prostate specific antigen in high concentration, definitely it is going to be the prostate gland, the secretory epithelium specifically, but semen, breast milk, amniotic fluid, endometrium and breast tissue also show you some expression of prostate specific antigen, but that is of not much clinical importance and the quantity is very less. So it is going to be specific for prostate only, normally secreted into seminal fluid. So it is necessary for liquefaction of seminal coagulum and cervical mucus. Then and then only the easy passage of sperms into the uterus will be facilitated if the seminal coagulum and cervical mucus are liquefied. Okay, that is the clinical significance of prostate specific antigen. Normal reference range is 1 to 5 microgram per liter. Coming to the clinical significance, the serum prostate specific antigen increased in physiological rise is seen immediately after recent ejaculation. Secretory epithelium is going to press prostate specific antigen and secrete in the semen, and along with that some fraction is going to be absorbed in the blood vessels. That's why the physiological rise is seen after recent ejaculation. CA prostate, because its normal reference range is less than 1, the level more than 10 is definitely of CA prostate, because it is very specific, may also detect prostatitis and benign prostatic hyperplasia, but level is not going to reach 10 microgram per liter in case of prostatitis and BHP. So the level more than 10 is going to be definitive of CA prostate. 30% of patients with high PSA have biopsy confirmed CA prostate. That's why prostate specific antigen is very specific for CA prostate and used to detect response to the treatment and its recurrence. In case of CA prostate, even if after removal of the prostate tissue, the clinicians do serial investigations of prostate-specific antigen so as to see the response to the treatment and find out any evidences of its recurrence in future. So thank you very much, guys. If you like the content and the efforts taken to prepare the presentations, please hit like button and share the videos. If you are not subscribed yet, kindly subscribe to the channel and hit the bell button so that you get the notifications in real time. Guys, please keep motivating us. Thank you so much.